There's been a mixed reaction to the AFL's three-match suspension handed to Port Adelaide's Jeremy Finlayson over a homophobic slur. Some say it goes further than the fine handed to North Melbourne coach Alistair Clarkson. Others are comparing it to Adelaide Crow Taylor Walker's six-match ban for a racist slur. One of Australia's most respected LGBTQIA plus advocates say bans alone are not enough. Ian Roberts is a patron of Pride in Sport and joins us now. Ian, great to have you with us.
Nice to be here.
Now, the AFL says without Finlayson's apologies for using the F word, the sanction would have been longer. So Finlayson apologised immediately the next day and then on Monday. Is that adequate?
Yes, no, yes, no. I mean, you're never going to please everyone. There's going to be people who obviously don't think it's long enough. There'd be plenty who think, it's probably excessive. But I think there's more at play here. This isn't about one situation, one act on one day. This kind of goes to culture of sport, the culture of the greater community. And it's kind of like how the governing bodies now move forward with this. This is why, I've been a big champion of stuff like Indigenous rounds and multicultural rounds and pride rounds. And this is kind of just that reason. It's about building community. Those rounds are all about saying everyone who plays his sport is welcome here. Mm. That's all they're saying. And that's what I think, we need to focus on. And I'm absolutely sure that Jeremy is heartfelt in his apology. And I understand also how easy it is in the heat of the moment for those things to happen. Mm. I mean, I've done and said things on a football field that I regretted. Jeremy, and we shouldn't be attacking Jeremy here. Like, he's owned the situation, he stood up. But it does say a lot about our culture and about our community when you can call someone gay and that somehow means that they're less.
Mm. Is there a symptom of culture if there aren't any openly gay players in the sport? You were the first NRL player to come out in 1995 and there hasn't been another player since then. Isaac Humphries was the first NBL player to come out a year and a half ago. Josh Cavallo was the first A-League player to come out 3 years ago. And there's never been an openly gay AFL men's player. Why do you think that is?
You would say it probably kind of reflects. This is a male problem, like a male, particularly teen sports problem. You've only got to look at the Matildas and how they were embraced by the public and the team themselves. They're so embracing of same-sex couples. This is really a male teen professional sport problem. And I would almost think, it's still seen. Being gay is emasculates or it somehow diminishes. It's seen to, or that it's weak. I do want to say earlier that you mentioned those players, Josh and Isaac, which is wonderful. There was a guy in 1990, Justin Fashanu, who came out in the English Premier League. I was going to come out that same year when I left South to go to Manly. But this was a time before we had mobile phones now. So if you had to, when you followed a story, you had to watch the news or listen to the radio or watch your TV. And Justin was brutalised by the English press and by supporters of the game. That was in 90. And I remember seeing that because I was going to come out the same year, and I was just like, oh, that's probably too much for me. He retired in 94. That's the year I came out, and he died of suicide in 98. Now, I mean, I hate to bring that up, but that's the consequences of just this type of thing. And that's where we need to go to with this. That's how serious this situation is. I really feel for all those kids out in the suburbs or the regional areas who are playing sport, who might be dealing with their own sexuality and issues around that. The sort of messages this sends. That's why, it's up now. It's really up to the governing, the bodies that... Of the sports, and it's all the codes. I mean, even the NRL. The NRL hasn't had any players come out. I mean, I came out when it was the ARL. That's how long ago it was. Mm.
And there would be gay players in these leagues.
I mean, I think it'd be very naive to think that there weren't. It's but again, we come to the culture of the sport. Why is it like that? I mean. And obviously, it's because players don't feel safe.
Mm. And as you said, they're not just words. There are consequences to using the words. What's needed then to cut through and change the use of those words?
Education, education, education. I mean, I really believe it's our greatest sword and shield in battling this situation and these issues. The NRL, I'm part of a program there around inclusion and diversity in their wellbeing unit. We speak to all the clubs, all the players in and around this subject matter, as well as other stuff. But, you know, we have to start somewhere. I'm coming mixed up now with Qtopia, which is a queer history and cultural centre, basically a museum. And that's all about education, and we're just rolling out programs now. There's syllabus and curriculum written for primary schools and high schools. That's where this stuff starts. And the governing bodies of these sports, you know, it starts at grassroots level. That's where we need to be educating people.
Well, Ian Roberts, thank you for joining us, and really appreciate your insights.
My pleasure.
Yeah, thanks again.